could take a beating like a good pair of headphones.
Joey. Andrew.
Joseph Heitzmann.
Joseph.
My son.
My son.
Andrew is the kind of character that if 2 ever gets big, every single person who watches it is going to have a crush on him.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I have to say, I feel like Andrew is more like me than I am like Scout. Because he's this really insecure guy, and he sort of spends all his time worrying about what people think about him. And he's this good-natured person, but you know, he's a little anxious. You know, he's a little bit sketchy because he did appear from nowhere.
He's a little cinnamon bun. He just wants to be loved, but then he's also like a soccer bro, so he's like a cinnamon bun trying to be cool.
But he's just not cool enough. And he gets sad.
Yeah, like, I feel like he's just like much more in tune with his emotions than guys are supposed to be, and so like, he doesn't know how to handle that because he's trying to be like open, and he definitely does
like,
have friends there, but then like, I think they tease him a lot. He doesn't really know how to handle that.
Andrew is interesting because his inward perspective on things is different from the others, in that it's pretty generally stated that he suffers from depression, and he's also had these massive mood swings issues, especially when he was younger, and he talks about it a little bit with Angelica, but the most of the time he doesn't want to talk about it because he thinks he'll be considered a loser or lame if he talks about having these problems, which is such a thing in our current society today. And there's just so many things about 2 that really need to be talked about, and that's one of them for me.
I agree. I also will say that Andrew, of all the characters in 2, I think is probably the most clueless one. I mean, Sawyer's pretty clueless, but Andrew usually really doesn't know what's going on.
None of them do, especially him.
None of them do, but usually he's the most out of the loop, partially because he's so focused on making a good impression on his friends, and he's like with them a lot. He has a lot of his own issues that he has to deal with.
It takes him a bit to notice the sci-fi shenanigans happening in the background.
Yeah.
What we love about Andrew is he is painfully human.
He is
pure. He cares a whole lot. I mean,
he's
one
heart.
Of the sweetest characters on the set in terms of how he just cares for both Angelica and Mikey, especially in the face of Angelica questioning who he is, especially in the beginning of the production.
Like,
He serves as he continues to worry about her, to step up, take care of Mikey. Even when she sort of rejects him as her brother, her twin brother.
And, like, even at that, because he's so genuine and, like, genuinely, like, sweet and friendly and helpful and caring of his family, who he hasn't been there in Angelica's eyes, Angelica almost, like, she seems to trust him sooner than Scout trusts Sawyer, because he, just of the way that he is, he's just, you want to trust him, even though, again, you don't know where he's from, what his motives are.
It's, like, need, I think, to fit in. But then he also feels at the same time that he doesn't fit in, so he, like, is in this weird dynamic where he's just really, like, kind of lonely. He doesn't feel like he has anyone.
Yeah. I mean, that was, like, a really big thing, is, like, at least with his interactions with Angelica, is, like, because he feels so isolated from so many of his friends, like, he and Angelica have always been, like, really close and, like, taking good care of Mikey, always, and, like, in his mind, like, they've always been super close. And so when she's kind of, like, I feel like it hurts him.
Yeah.
Like,
Angelica, the way he sees Angelica is, like, he sees her as, like, the only real root.
Like, safe place.
Yeah. Safe place is a good word. Good
words.
He's kind of similar to Angie in some ways, in the way that he's, like, he plays soccer, and he has friends and a life and everything, but mostly he is different because of this internal perspective that he has.
It really hurts to see him hurting.
It's so painfully relatable, too.
So,
like, everyone has felt a little bit like how he feels, like he's not good enough.
But in that, he's overall a happy character. Like, like, despite the sadness that his character causes you to feel, he's a very, very happy character.
Let's go. Super hands in, go.
I can take a hit like Karate Kid. You know, you can learn a lot from a good pair of headphones.
making bloopers.
Yes.
Sha-la-la-la-la-la, got the boy to...
He's, may have the worst luck. He's gotten injured a few times on set. I can count three major times that he's gotten seriously injured on set.
Urgent care.
One of the times did result in urgent care. But he's very fun to have around.
He's really enthusiastic.
Yeah.
We're pretty, I love working with Joey. We work really well together, and so it's really fun to get to work with him. He's also a very needed part of the cast because Craig and I both have a lot of anxiety about things, and Joey's not one of those people. He is, he's just super chill and very focused like Kristen, and he's just like, nope, we're gonna do this, we're gonna get through this, and, I think I would have exploded a lot sooner if it weren't for Joey.
You're so funny. So it's like a good time, because like, I don't know, like the way we were saying, like everyone else, especially in the core four, like would get stressed out, like Craig would get stressed out, I would, Jordan would, and you're always just like, ah, guys, and then you like bring up something random.
Got a movie on Murder on the Polar Express.
Orient Express?
Orient Express.
Polar Express has been me. Joey is one of the most fun people to work with.
Accurate. There's so many things I could say about this that I probably shouldn't.
He's so honestly fun. Just so much fun. And, like, generally just a little ray of sunshine.
Yeah.
He's great. I love him.
So, Joey. Oh, God. What can't be said about Joey?
Aw, Joey.
We love him. We love him to death. He is, I think he's the collective baby brother of everybody, in two that is qualified.
With fun facts, like, I don't know if you guys noticed, he's 2 years younger than most of us.
Yeah.
He doesn't seem like it. He's such a good job of, like, portraying someone who's much more mature than, like, age-wise than he is.
Yeah.
But he's, like, a year or two younger than all of us.
And,
he's also, like, the youngest person on the main cast, which is really weird. Because he's definitely the best actor on the main cast, but then, and we'll forget how young he is, and then randomly something will happen, and he'll be like, I'm studying for the SAT, and we'll be like,
what? Or he'll be like, guys, I just got my license, and we're like,
I don't have my license.
Well.
Out of the people in the show, some of us are actors, and some of us are not. And you're definitely, like, on the actor side of things, so it's really cool because you, like, get the character really well, and it makes it better for the rest of us.
He's hard to get to focus, but when you do get him to focus, he's very good at what
God
he does. Huh?
He's like God tier as an actor. It's really disconcerting.
Yeah.
And he keeps on getting this like cult following within the show. These people who are just like, hashtag Andrew Defense Squad.
No, like seriously, he's going to have a lot of fangirls if this ever...
We originally had someone else playing Andrew, and then they had some scheduling conflicts, mm-hmm. and so they had to leave the production. So we were like, what are we gonna do?
We were in panic mode. It was looking like two was gonna happen.
Yeah.
And then Joey comes up, and wow, he just blows us all away. We were thankful that he showed up and agreed to play such a big character.
Let alone
in general. But he came in and he knocked it out of the park. Like he, oh God.
All his scenes are so good. And, like, he actually, like, is the only soccer bro who actually knows how to play soccer, which was a nice thing to have.
Oh, hey!
I gotta take a beating. I know I did.
Do you have any stories from working with Joey?
Hat. Guys, I found a hat. Oh, my God! Definitely the best
scene in the show.
Yeah. Just do your weird beauty shit.
That's like, definitely the best scene in the show.
It's a real, real good scene. Also, did she have hella boobs?
Hella boobs. You were at a party last night.
Just because we're twins doesn't mean we have the same crap.
One of my favorite stories with Joey is, so at one point we're in the forest, and he is walking on this log and starts singing, I forget what song, I think it was like Celine Dion or something.
And
he, yes!
Will always.
And he actually was singing really well, but then all of a sudden, he slips on moss on the trunk, both of his legs go opposite ways, and then you just hear a yelp, and he flips over the log and lands like, it was a pretty far drop in the bushes.
I forgot you were there for that. Yeah.
It was so funny. Best blooper
I was
had.
Not paying attention to that because I was like stressed. So I was just like pacing back and forth and I heard that happening in the background.
It
like,
was very funny. Up, he got poison ivy.
The way we said lines and like change lines to like fit our characters and our moods in the moment, like I feel like that was just really fun to do. Like,
and I think between the two of us, we kind of added like this little playfulness to the relationship between Andrew and Angelica. They're like very, even though they're like they get serious, they're like really playful and just kind of fuck around a lot.
Okay, so the first time I met Joey Heitzmann, he was in my backyard. And my mom, being the nice lady that she is, put out a giant bowl of watermelon. Yeah. I turned my back for approximately 2 seconds, and I find Joey and Josh throwing watermelon rinds at each other aggressively. And I had to be like, guys, stop.
There was like a scene where we went and filmed the daycare, and all the kids met him, and like 5 minutes later, they're just climbing all over him.
Oh, I punched him in the nose.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Shit. Did you actually hit him?
Yeah.
Oh okay, my
we're
God.
Good.
And he's like, guys, let's get the fight going so we can use this blood in the fight. Let's get this seat.
Joey was the last member of the main cast to be cast for complicated reasons. So he came on really late. And because we had been having such issues with Andrew, he was like the worst written person in the script. I can say as a screenwriter, like he was just a mess. He was annoying. He was like over. He whined all the time. He didn't know what was going on. We were like, how is anybody going to root for him? And then I was there the first time Joey was on set. And so he like stands up there and he like delivered his lines. And I was just like,
sugar.
He's interesting. Like that's Joey takes what was on paper, this like wet, gross, moldy part, and makes him interesting and very multifaceted. And then it's wild how good Joey is at what he does.
Just that you can act. Like you and O'Keefe are like our hardcore best actors. Matt, beginning. Nah.
I remember we were all sitting there reading the script for Andrew, and none of us knew how to fix the lines.
Just like how he fixes, and we were like, we can't. And then Joey was like, I can work with this.
Yeah.
He's really a trooper. Despite him not being involved in the production for as long as we have been, he sacrificed as much, if not more.
He did. He was such a good fit for our production. I'm really grateful that he's been in it.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then he also has a trick where he can cry on command. And so he's just like, wait a minute, let it roll down my cheek. Like, he's just trying to get the tear to roll down his cheek before he says his next line. He's like, wait. Okay, and now I can do it. Just his commitment to scenes is so fun.
Of a better man. I'm taking you off. Holding your hand, it's your favorite band.
Booty shit.
There's so many good scenes of Andrew.
I think... Well, all of my scenes with Andrew involved stunts, and, I mean, it varied depending on that, but one of them was really hard for me just because I think I got a concussion from it. I didn't actually get a concussion from it, obviously, but it hurt a lot more than I thought it would, but I couldn't complain because Matt had just, like, dug a hole for a scene, and Joey does all sorts of things, so it was, like, I really couldn't complain about it. The other fun scene I filmed with Joey was... We had to collide with each other, and we kept messing it up because it took us like 10 tries to make it look natural because we couldn't make it look natural until eventually we just had to do it so I was out of control and that I actually like tripped into him. No.
Basically, he threw a stick at me.
I knew you were going to say that one.
He threw a stick at me, and the first few times we did it for other angles, it was fine. And then the last scene we did with the angles from like... It was from me behind me, and you see Joey throw the stick at me, and it barely grazes my head, okay? But I had complete trust in Joey, and
never.
You know what? We did the scene right.
There's one scene later on. It's very, very, like, emotionally intense, and that was, like, a really, it was really cool to
It's emotionally intense for me, sort of.
Yeah. I mean, it's emotionally intense for me, too, because I don't, like, none of us, like, we don't want to tell you anything, and you don't want to hear it, and it's just, like, it's just really tough. It's just...
Can I? I don't think I can tease my favorite Andrew scenes, because they're all spoilery.
Yeah, they're all towards the end.
So, I'm just gonna say that there's some stuff that happens later in the show that's really quality, and Joey's acting's very good.
There's a scene from the end of 107 that is probably, aside from the scene right after it, one of my favorite scenes in all of 2, and I was, when I read it for the first time, I was like, we have to do 107 purely because I want to see Joey do this scene. And then I got to be there when we did this scene, and... It's so good. Guys, you don't even know. It's so good.
But anyway, the thing about Joey is he's just like a little theater baby, and him and I have had so many good bands about theater, and whenever I want to just talk to someone about theater, I just hit up Joey and I text him and I'm like, hey, this show, and then he'll give me 20 opinions about that show, and that's what I love about Joey.
Especially thank Joey just because we had such a difficult time casting his character.
For various complicated reasons.
Yeah. We had someone before who was very complicated to get to do things and then just, like, dropped out of it entirely. So we were very fortunate to have Joey, who's such a great actor and so fun on set, to join us.
It was so, like, we were feeling so pessimistic about Andrew, and then Joey stepped on set, and we were just like, wow, what kind of upgrade? Like,
God bless.
How did this happen? Did you, like, it's like going from an iPhone to, like, a good Galaxy phone. It was amazing, because iPhones suck.
Yeah, Joey's quality. We love and appreciate Joey. 2 and Andrew would not be what they are without Joey Heitzmann.
Mm-hmm.
And I've talked to Craig about this. Andrew, originally as a character, especially because of where he's coming from, can kind of be a little bit of a wet mop just in writing. Mm-hmm. But Joey's just brought this interesting life to the character that's so cool. Like... And now when I read Andrew, I have to read it the way Joey plays it because I can't imagine the character any other way.
I'm so glad we got Joey.
Oh.
I'm so glad he's my brother.
cut.
Oh, no, I can get it. No.
Okay, you might have.